Gentlemen, stay away from the ambulance, please.
Gents,
ladies,
can
we get well away
from the fence? Thank you. Right, what have we got? Assault on a vagrant, Sarge. Someone set fire to him.
What's his condition?
Not much to look at. He got burns to the face and hands, plus quite a nasty head wound. They're taking him to St. Hugh's.
Do we know who he is?
Seems he's just a tramp, Sarge.
Well, that makes it all right.
Well back, please, sir.
Was he sleeping on the bench?
Looks that way, yes.
Right, let's get this area taped off. Soccer?
On the way, Sarge.
Good.
What about these people? Any witnesses?
Not had a chance to ask yet, Sarge.
We'll get cracking before they move off.
He won't be able to talk to you at the moment.
How's he doing?
Not too bad, considering. These people are not in the best of health to start with. He was wearing thick clothing, so it could have been worse.
Can you keep us informed of his situation? We really need to get a description of his attacker as soon as possible.
Excuse me, love. Did you happen to know the gentleman?
What? Yeah. He was in a park every day when it was nice. That tape recorder of his.
Tape recorder, yeah?
Yeah, a big radio cassette thing. Played music on it.
Right, and did anybody ever give him any trouble that you know of?
What, you mean kids?
Well, whoever.
Nah. There's some people around here who don't like the homeless. But I can't think who'd want to do that. He didn't mean to harm no one.
Right.
He's found something. Look, he's found something.
If you could just stay here a second, madam. What you got there, Steve?
Sorry about
it. Petrol.
Thanks. Hopefully we should get a good set of fingerprints off that.
Any joy with the public?
The usual. Like the three wise monkeys, except nobody's wise. You didn't happen to find a tape recorder, did you?
No, why?
Well, that woman with the kids written this character always had a tape recorder with him.
Yeah? Well, maybe that's what it's about, then.
Why try and kill a nobody?
Kicks.
Attacks have been reported before, not that we've been able to do much about them.
You had contact with these dossers before, didn't you?
Yeah.
So what did they say?
Reckon it was some lads from the Beckett estate.
Probably jealous. I'd rather sleep on a park bench than live in those flats.
Yeah, but this is a bit strong, isn't it? Perhaps it just got out of hand.
Do you want to go back and have another word with him?
Yep, no problem.
It's worth a couple of your lads knocking up the residents of the Beckett estate. Somebody might have seen something.
Loxton and Garfield are already onto it, sir.
Do we know who our pal is?
No, he's not fit to tell us anything at the moment. There's no ID. He's a non-person, sir.
I'll leave this one with you then, Frank.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Here we go. Case of the week. GBH on an unnamed tramp on the Beckett estate. No witnesses.
Probably another dosser. Some of these old boys can get a bit serious when they fall out.
What about Ron Smollett? His own beat covers that area.
Nah, I doubt if it was him, Tosh.
Oh, very funny. Find Ron and get on with it.
Right, Tosh. Find Ron and get on with it.
All right, Tommy. How's it going?
All right.
Has there been any trouble around here recently?
Not since I got the dog.
Listen, there was an attack over at Jackson Park this morning. Do you know anything? Old bloke. Somebody set fire to him.
Won't help.
This bloke lived. The next one might not be so lucky.
Thought that's what you wanted.
How do you mean, mate?
Well, if we're dead, we're not a problem, are we?
So you don't know this bloke? Carried around a tape recorder, liked his music.
You mean Mick?
Do I?
Oh, there you are, Ron. I've been looking for you.
What's the problem?
This attack in Jackson Park, it's on your beat, isn't it?
Yes, on the fringes.
Any likely faces?
Not as yet, but I'm on my way out there now. Anything comes up, I'll let you know.
I'll come with you, Ronnie.
I'd rather ask around on my own, thanks, Tosh. They're just getting to know me out there now and, well, you know how it is, eh? Suit yourself.
Yeah, about 10 o'clock this morning.
No, I've never seen a thing. These people are trouble anyway. They ask you for money, and they don't care where they go to the toilet.
Oh, thank you very much, madam.
How's it going?
Pathetic.
Hello, Mr. Smollett. How's it going?
Can't complain.
How are things here, all right?
Oh, Bizzo, Mr. Smollett. Bizzo. No trouble at all. I think people got the message.
Message?
Well, if you want to have a good time, you want to make friends, come round. But if you want trouble, stay away.
I heard you had trouble getting the dealers to stay away.
Well, nothing I could handle.
Do you hear what happened in Jackson Park this morning?
Yeah. Terrible.
Any names spring to mind?
No. Can't help you.
Where do they go, the troublemakers?
Well, once they're out of here, they're not my problem. It's none of my business. Look, I don't mean to be rude.
Tony, you must have heard something.
Nothing. Sorry. Chris. All right, guys.
Where's my clothes? What have you done with them? There's things that I...
Sierra Oscar from 577.
Go ahead, Barry.
I'm down at St. Hugh's, Skip. Apparently, the victim from that attack at Jackson Park is fit to question. Can you tell Sergeant Maitland?
Why aren't you still here?
Ron wanted to sound the estate out on his own. Sensitive area. All that old cobblers.
Tosh, I want you to go. I want this sorted. Ron will come back with a load of can't reveal my sources, if buts and rumours.
He won't. And anyway, I've got all this to do. Look at it.
Listen, until further notice, I'm the DI. So don't argue about it. Just do it, all right?
They must print that line of the DI's handbook.
Morning, madam.
How'd you find out?
Beg your pardon?
That it was me phoned the ambulance. I didn't think they could trace calls like that. Well, that's why you're here, isn't it?
Yeah, but I didn't know it was you. We're calling on all the residents.
Any luck?
I thought I told you to stay clear.
Yeah, well, I'm only following orders. Come on, get in.
No joy, I'm afraid.
Well, that's not very good, is it? I thought Tony was supposed to be your eyes and ears on the Beggar estate.
He is.
Yeah, well, he only tells you what he wants to tell you.
You've got to build relationships in my job, Tosh. Gain a bit of trust, a bit of credibility.
Just as long as it's not a substitute for nicking people.
Give me time.
How long do you need? A year or two? Oh. Jackson
Park. Hang on a minute.
Go ahead with details. A Mrs. Fisher, 63 Elliott House, Beckett Estate.
Sierra Oscar from 330. Tosh Lines and I can meet with Garfield there in 2 minutes.
Not too long, okay?
Okay. Barry, what's his full name?
Michael Donaldson.
Right. Hello, Mr. Donaldson. I'm Sergeant Maitland from Sunhill Police. I'd like to ask you a few questions about this morning.
Yeah. No one's called me Mr. for a while.
You tell us what happened, please?
I was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
You were under the impression that someone attacked you?
That's what I meant. I don't think he was out to get me in particular.
He? There was only one?
That's right.
Can you describe him?
It happened too fast. They all look the same these days. Stupid haircuts, the clothes.
Had you seen him before?
No.
Are you sure? I mean, there have been other attacks on homeless people.
And there always will be. Look, I don't need all these questions. I'm the victim.
Yeah, look, I understand. It's just that I want to get the person that did it.
I wouldn't waste your time.
What do you mean by that?
Even if you find who did it, nothing will happen, will it?
I was talking to some mates of yours around the estate this morning.
None mates of mine.
Woman up there reckoned you're always good for a few quid.
Women, always after your money. Nothing but trouble.
Where'd you get your money from, Mr. Donaldson?
From using my brain.
You're a smart bloke, then.
Smart enough. No, if you don't mind, I'm going to get some kit. I'm tired.
Well, I was doing me hoovering.
About what time, love?
Well, I suppose about 10:30. I went to open the window and I heard the shouting. I looked out and I saw these two blokes arguing with a tramp. One of them hit him, poured something on him. Must have been petrol because he set light to it. That's when I dialed 999.
So, what about these two blokes?
Well, the tramp, he had a radio. One of the blokes took it off him. That's what they argued about, I think. They went out of the park by that gate, down to the old lockups, and disappeared.
OK, we'll go down and have a look. Now, Mrs. Fisher, you say that you know them.
Oh, well, the one who took the radio, I know him. I've seen him before.
What does he look like?
Well, he's kind of small, blonde, but it's his face. Oh.
What about him?
Well, It's all scarred, as if you'd been slashed with a knife. Oh, it'll give you the creeps, honestly.
Got this on your list of places to visit?
To be honest, I didn't know there was any action down here.
Somebody's doing good business.
No sign of our two blokes, though.
Why do you run down here if you've just attacked somebody?
Home turf. Somewhere you feel safe, where no one will bother you.
You'd feel safe down here.
Druggies,
pushers and users. That's just what I thought. Small and blonde. I think that's the one.
Derek Mitchell, done for possession of heroin 6 months ago.
What'd he get?
3 months suspended. He's also a known associate of Paul Phillips.
Paul Phillips, possession with intent to supply amphetamines. 1 year suspended sentence, second offence.
He got off lightly.
Drug squad arrest.
Do you know either of them?
Oh, yeah. Mitchell, spent a lot of time down the community centre.
And Phillips?
Nasty. This ABH here. He was involved in a ruck down the community centre not long after Tony took over.
Drugs related?
Almost certainly. Rumour was that Phillips was dealing and Tony's very anti-drugs.
Yeah, well, thanks, Lil. Can you do us a favour? Can you check with Soko and see if Phillips and Mitchell's prints match those on the petrol container?
Yeah, sure.
Tar, what do you reckon?
Well, if Phillips was aged out of the community centre, then the lockups probably became his new venue.
Yeah, well, how's this tie-in with him and Mitchell attacking Mick?
What's a tramp got that a small-time dope dealer needs?
A tape recorder?
His full name is Michael Donaldson. He can't remember what happened, no description, nothing.
Do you believe him?
Not for a minute.
Any progress?
Yeah, we've got two names, Paul Phillips and Derek Mitchell.
Our witness says she saw two blokes arguing with Mick. Now, these are the most likely. She said she could ID Mitchell for sure.
I'm not surprised.
Hang on, two people.
That's what she said, yeah.
When I spoke to Mick, he didn't mention anything about an argument, nothing like that.
For a victim, he's not very forthcoming.
Maybe he's scared.
Okay, John. Get back to the hospital, have another word with Mick. We'll pick up Phillips and Mitchell, see what they say.
Right.
Sir. Thought you'd want to know, that print from the petrol can, Soko says the yards matched it to Phillips.
We're in business. Thanks, love.
Yeah?
We're looking for your son, Derek.
He's not here. Look! I told you! He's not here! Oi, what are you doing? I mean, I got my rights, haven't I?
So have we, love.
I'm telling you, he's not here.
So where is he then?
I kicked him out. Didn't pay no rent. I'm going to get a lodger.
What, around here?
Do you know Paul Phillips? Know where he is?
Our home.
His place is empty. He's moved out.
Well, it's a bad area. Some people can't handle it.
Come on, Tosh.
See you, Matthew. See you tomorrow. What's this all about?
We've got a description of someone running away from the scene of that attack I told you about.
So?
The description fits Derek Mitchell. Do you know
him? A bit. He's been in here. Hangs around, you know.
Why didn't you tell me about him earlier?
Because Derek wouldn't do a thing like that. I know him.
You didn't tell me about the lockups either.
You'd have found out about those sooner or later.
Oh, yeah. When we pick up the likes of Mitchell OD down there. Now, come on, Tony.
What? Mitchell's clean.
God, I told him. Told him what?
Nothing.
Not your business.
Right.
Look, it's only a matter of time before Mitchell gets nicked. Everything's loaded against him. Now he's going to take the rap for something that he's only a part of.
You're either guessing or you know more than you're letting on, Mr. Smollett.
I don't know enough, Tony, because you...
Because I what? I won't play the white man. Naming names to keep you sweet.
No. No, that's not what I meant. I don't want to see the wrong person arrested. I'm trying to build bridges around here. And I'm asking you so that we can avoid some aggravation.
If, and I mean if, Derek was involved, it wouldn't have been his idea.
Tony, if you know, you've got to tell me what happened.
Have I? Like I keep telling you, it's none of my business.
I'm not sure my colleagues will see it like that. If I don't walk out of here with some information...
Don't lean on me. That's not the way we work together.
Look. You know that Phillips is a dealer, part of the problems of this place.
Yes.
You also know that Derek is a victim of those problems.
So what?
If you know that much about something, then it definitely is your business, whether you like it or not.
Listen, I don't know it all, okay? But the tramp who got torched, he had something on Phillips. He slept in the lockup. Phillips uses that place like he used to use this place.
Do you know where he is?
No. He's not easy to find. He doesn't live on the estate anymore.
And Derek?
He's got a problem. A dope problem. Yeah, you guessed that right. And he owes Phillips more than he can ever pay. Do you understand me? He's just a Joey, really.
Where can I find him?
Harrington Walk, other side of the estate. He's squatting in a flat there, one the council forgot about. Number 1A. He's been there since his mother kicked him out.
Cheers, Tony.
Yeah, cheers. You know, maybe it was better when people like you and me just didn't talk to each other.
How are you feeling, Mr. Donaldson?
You're back. Call me Mick. I'm not Mr. Donaldson.
You going to tell us what really happened, Mick?
I've given you a statement.
We've got a witness now. The woman who called the ambulance.
Well, like I said, I've given you a statement.
Trouble is, I don't believe you.
Your problem?
Look, whatever it is you're scared of...
Listen, son. I've spent 30 years on the street. There's nothing left for me to be scared of.
No, okay. But why are you lying?
You, nurse, where's my gear? I want to get out.
Are you sure about this, Ron? How am I supposed to police this place unless I know what's going on? I mean, you go in here today, then you're out of it. I'm the one who's got to answer the questions tomorrow.
Yeah, but how can you square knocking a door in with being Mr. Community, eh?
Soft is the last thing I want to look round here. And anyway, you're the one who's knocking the door in, George.
Come on, what else?
Is this your tape recorder?
Look, I don't know nothing about it.
Okay, have it your own way. Tosh, attempted murder.
Look, it's Paul's tape recorder, that's all I know, right?
Where is he?
He's gone looking for Mick. He said something about a tape. He gave me the machine.
Where's he gone?
To the hospital.
I keep telling you, there was no argument.
But our witness specifically...
Stuff your witness, she got it wrong.
Look, I'm sure you're well enough to leave.
I don't like being shut in, I'll survive.
What about this tape recorder? How long have... Come on, lie back down, I'll get an answer. Sister?
Yes?
Got a problem. Michael Donaldson.
Hello, mate. Come to visit you.
Leave me alone! Hey, you, give me that back!
Oi! What the hell do you think you're doing?
He's got me tight!
All right, sit down!
He's got me tight!
Assault. You don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but anything you do say may be given in evidence.
You got nothing.
I've got this. Get it. I don't think you realise how much trouble you're in. It's ABH for a start, GBH, maybe attempted murder.
Don't make me laugh.
No laugh, mate. Not when you set fire to people.
I don't know what you're talking about. I've had enough of this. I'm saying nothing more, not to you. I'm only talking to Mr. Houlihan.
Houlihan? His drug squad.
This is what the fight was over.
Let's have a listen.
So, what you got for me? Now, this is the business.
That's Phillips.
But he's going to do the drop Thursday at the docks. He drives this blue Sierra.
Oh, yeah.
In and out of London. When's it supposed to happen? Half eight. Straight up, Mr. Ritter. It was the same last time. Miller comes in, clocks Bucky, then...
So, Phillips is a grass.
How the hell did Mick manage to tape that?
A hole in the wall.
What?
In the lockup. Mick must have slept there. Maybe when he realised that Phillips was an informer, he taped him.
Blackmail.
Yeah, the last thing Phillips needs is for everyone to know that he's a grass. Must have been how Mick got his money.
Crafty old so-and-so.
I'll get on to drug squad.
Nearly got him killed.
You got to hand it to him, though. With planning an observation like that, he should be in the department. Could make DI in a month.
We know Mick had been taping you. What was the deal? You slip him a few quid every week to keep it to himself?
No comment.
Get greedy, did he? Want more money?
No comment.
Was it worth trying to kill him for? Interview interrupted.
Oh, sorry, Sergeant. There's a D.I. Hooler here to see you. I've parked him up in CI,
thing. All right, Reece, thank you.
Now we'll get somewhere.
Alistair, this is D.I. Patrick Hoolahan from Drugs.
Right, we spoke on the phone.
That's right. I was just explaining to your DCI here the situation. Phillips is my informant, and the good one.
So I gather. Doesn't mean to say he can go around torching people, though, does he?
No, of course not. What I was saying is he's come up with solid information in the past, and if possible, I wouldn't want to lose him.
Maybe you should have kept a tighter rein on him.
Yeah, all right, Alistair. All Patrick wants is damage limitation.
That's right. I mean, it's not like he took a box of swan to the Lady Mayoress, is it? Just some vagrant, wasn't it? Listen, as far as I'm concerned, a crime's a crime. I don't operate on a league table basis.
No one's saying you do. But Phillips was leading us to the middlemen. People like Buckley. We could crack a major ring.
I'm sure Alistair appreciates that.
Of course, Goff.
So how much is on paper?
Nothing, to be honest. Isn't going to speak till he's talked to you.
If he hasn't been charged yet, the ball's back in your court.
As it happens, Patrick, the ball never left our court. You've got to see our point of view. This is going to be all over the papers tomorrow. I want a swift result.
Look, Phillips is the closest we've got to Buckley.
If I could give you another name, someone to take Phillips' place, you'd owe us one.
Alistair, we're all on the same side.
Derek Mitchell. As far as I can gather, he's slower than Phillips, but he's got a healthy habit. You keep him in jollies, he'll get you information.
Alistair, there's a callous streak in you I could get to admire.
But you said immunity.
Not for GBH.
But these homeless are rubbish. And that Mick had a tape of me telling you... He was out of order. He wanted more. He said he was going to give that tape to Buckley. He would have done me. And that would have wrecked the whole operation.
Operation? What do you think? You've got a bit part in Mission Impossible? All you've done is get yourself blackmailed by a tramp and caused me a lot of aggravation. Attempted murder? I should think that would stick.
You what? Don't you understand? I was helping you. Now you've got to help me.
Help you, Paul? If you were on fire, I wouldn't cross the street to pee on you.
Right, we're going to find you a place in a hostel somewhere.
I already told you I don't like being shut in.
It's all right, Mick. It's just to make sure you're safe. And so we know where to find you when it's time to go to court.
And after that, after court, what's going to happen to me?
Well,
I had an income, some security. Now what am I going to do?